The Dutch Reformed Church officially lost 20,000 members last year, but the real numbers are likely to be much higher. We travelled to Dullstroom to find out why the formerly omnipotent Afrikaner church seems to be in trouble.
I think people leave the Dutch Reformed Church because they are sick and tired of the politics in it, you know. And they don't want to go to church and keep on feeling, oh, you know, we've got the whole apartheid thing on our neck. I once had interviews with, I think, 20 men. Why are they leaving the Dutch Reformed Church for a charismatic church? And these were the things they say, you know. They don't want to be like their fathers. They don't want to put on jackets and stand up when you pray. You may not lift your arms and things like that. They do not feel free in the Dutch Reformed Church.
Die kerk is onderstel om 'n presbyteriaanse stelsel te wees, waar daar nie hierdie hiërargiese strukture is nie, maar in die praktyk, ongelukkig gebeur dit baie keer sodat jy wel hierdie struktuur het. Asof jy mense wil beheer, asof jy wil beheer hê oor dit wat gedoen word.
Nie veel van ons, ek sien 'n paar ouens wat.
In die verlede het jy baie keer gehoor dat mense die kerk verlaat het as gevolg van sekere besluite wat geneem is. En op hierdie stadium hoor ek maar by ons eie lidmate dat mense onseker word oor die rol wat die kerk in die samelewing speel omdat daar nie besluite geneem word nie. Die synode het besluit dat daar meer versigtig met sake te werk gegaan moet word, so daar's baie meer tyd vir bespreking en ons wil graag na almal se verhale luister, maar lidmate beleef dit as 'n kerk wat nie meer 'n standpunt inneem nie. En dit veroorsaak dat mense sê, maar ek wil dan liewerste na 'n kerk toe gaan wat vir my definitiewe antwoorde kan gee in 'n tyd waar mense maar baie onseker is en onveilig voel.
Just 5 minutes down the road is the Uniting Reformed Church in Sakhelwe, where Christina Landman is the Reverend. It is the amalgamation of the Dutch Reformed Church's black and coloured sister churches and is flourishing.
You know, today there were not so many people. Usually we are so many that we've done bangs by the fensters, right? And especially if it rains, you know, the roof leaks and then people sit on each other's laps. We are building a new church. Why? There is a church.
Ons het verlede jaar vir die eerste keer nou saam met die VGK hier 'n gesamentlike diens gehou en dit was regtig 'n belewenis gewees. Maar tog na afloop van die diens kon jy voel dat daar tog 'n mate van ongemaklikheid was. Nie in die diens self nie, maar jy kon dit het gevoel amper asof die mense van die VGK gevoel het maar hulle hoort nie regtig hier nie. Dit is nie gesê nie. Toe ons na die tyd gaan tee drink het, daar's onsekerheid. Mense staan buite eenkant in groepies en moet jy sê man kom ons gaan nou saam in die saal tee drink en dan sal die mense instap en gesels, maar ons nog steeds amper 'n tipe van groepvorming van albei kante af.
That's what I say, how are we going to unite? We had this wonderful service together. But I could see that day. You've heard how they sing today. Eh? Were so robust and from their hearts. That day they could hardly make a sound. They were terrified. They were terrified in that church. And I almost couldn't, you know, they were just standing there and now they are here. You know, have to sing for the boss and everybody. It was very threatening, actually. The white people just continue saying, why don't I open it? Why don't I open it? Because, you know, I don't know what they thought we were doing. Maybe they thought we were praying to the ancestors or something. And they were surprised to see that we've got Bibles. And we've got actually, like, hymn books, you know, and sometimes we sing the same hymns as they. They were absolutely stand, you know.
Die ideaal is Jesus dat almal saam kan kerk en saam die Here kan eer. Maar ek weet nie of die kultuur en die taalverskille dit wel gaan toelaat nie. Die Afrikaanse mense sit met 'n geweldige groot vrees met 'n baie groot onsekerheid. So nou sit jy met 'n klomp mense wat onseker is. Hy is onseker oor die taal waarin sy kind gaan skool gaan. Hy is onseker of hy gaan werk kry as gevolg van BEE. Hy is onseker of hy sy plaas gaan hou. En die laaste vesting wat van hierdie mense het, voel hulle, is die kerk. So ek die kerk moet Afrikaans wees en die kerk moet gereformeerd wees en die kerk moet so lyk. En die oomblik as al begin praat word oor eenwording, as jy hulle wil my kerk ook vir my al wegvat sodat ek niks moet oor hê nie.